Welcome children, I hope you all have enjoyed the last class. Children, now I'm going to give answers for the test about types of soil in India. Types of soil in India are alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil, forest and mountain soil, arid and desert soil, saline and alkaline soil, peaty and marshy soil. Children, now we are going to learn about irrigation. Watering of agricultural plants through artificial means is called irrigation, where rainfall is inadequate or unreliable, irrigation is necessary for agriculture. Being a hot country with seasonal and irregular rainfall, it always needs irrigation to carry out agricultural activities during dry period. Besides erratic rainfall, prevalence of high temperature, cultivation of annual crops and hydropipes, commercial farming and porous soil make irrigation an essential one for the agriculture of our country. Now let's see about source of irrigation. In India, different sources of irrigation are used depending upon the topography, soils, rainfall, availability of surface or groundwater, nature of river, requirements of crops, etc. The main source of irrigation used in different parts of the country are canal irrigation, well irrigation and tank irrigation. In first, let's learn about canal irrigation. It is the second most important source of irrigation in our country. Percentage of area under canal irrigation in our country is 24%. Canals are the effective source of irrigation in areas of low relief, deep fertile soils, perennial source of water and extensive common area. The canals are of two types, inundation canals and perennial canals. In first, let's learn about inundation canals. In this, water is taken out directly from the rivers without making any kind of barrage or dam. Such canals are useful for diversion of flood water from the rivers and remain operational during rainy season. Next, perennial canals. These are developed from perennial rivers by constructing barrage to regulate the flow of water. In our country, most of the canals fall under this category. These canals are useful for irrigation. Now, well irrigation. A well is a hole, usually vertical excavated in the earth for bringing groundwater to the surface. Well irrigation is the most important source of irrigation as it contributes about 62% of net irrigated area in India. Wells are two types. Open wells and tube wells. First, open wells. This type of irrigation is widely practiced in the areas where groundwater is sufficiently available. The areas in Ganga Plains, the Delta region of Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri and parts of Narmada and Tapti valleys. Next, two wells. Two wells are developed in the areas of low water table, sufficient power supply and soft subsurface geological units. Two wells are predominant in the states of Gujarat, Maharashtra, Punjab, Madhya Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Tank irrigation. A tank is a natural or man-made hollow on the surface developed by constructing a small bund around it across a stream. It is used to collect and store water for irrigation and other purposes. Irrigation by tanks is a very old system in India. It also includes irrigation from lakes and ponds. The tank irrigation is popular in the peninsular India due to following reasons. The undulating relief and hard rocks make difficult to dig canals and wells. Natural depressions serve as reservoirs. Absence of perennial rivers. Impermeable rock structure which do not percolation. The scattered nature of population and agricultural fields. Modern irrigation methods. There are many ways in modern irrigation, among them mostly practiced and following in India are using drips, sprinklers and poly houses, central pivot irrigation. Drip irrigation. In drip irrigation, water is delivered at or near the root zone of plants drop by drop. It will cover a tiny area at plant, but suitable for big trees and horticulture plants too, which used to grow bigger. Rain gun. Rain gun used to spread water like rain, as in name, and used to serve for crops, which used to grow up to 4 feet or high also. But we have to adjust sprinklers height as per crop size. Center pivot irrigation, sometimes called central pivot irrigation, also called water wheel and circle irrigation, is a method of crop irrigation in which equipment rotates around a pivot and crops are watered with sprinklers. Next, multi-purpose river valley projects. It is a scientific management of water resources in our country. Construction of dam across river is aimed at many purposes. Hence, it's termed as multi-purpose river valley projects. Bakra Nangal Dam. It's the highest gravity dam in the world. This dam built across the river Satluj. Through this project, Jharkhand, West Bengal are benefited. Mettur Dam
built across the river Kaveri. Through this project, Tamil Nadu benefited.
Naharjuna Sagar Dam. This dam built across the river Krishna. Through this project, Andhra Pradesh benefited. Sardar Sarovar Dam. This dam built across the river Narmada. Through this project, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and Rajasthan are benefited.
Hirakud Dam. It's longest dam in the world. This dam built across the river Mahanadi. Through this project, Orissa benefited. Teri Dam. This dam built across the river Bhagirathi. Through this project, Uttarakhand benefited.
Kosi Dam. This dam built across the river Kosi. The Kosi River, known as the Saro of Bihar, has shifted its course by about 100 km in the recent times. Through this project, Bihar, Nepal are benefited.
Okay, children. Thank you. Have a nice day.